Have you noticed when you've logged into your analytics, there's this new beta studio option? Have you tried it out? Not sure what you're even looking at? In today's video, I'm gonna show you some pretty cool statistics that you can get from the new YouTube studio beta, how to find that, and how to use it to make your videos better. Hi, my name is Trena. If you are new here and on this channel, I help creative entrepreneurs just like you get on YouTube to help you grow your business. And one of the biggest things that can help you grow your YouTube channel, which in turn helps you grow your business, is really understanding your analytics. I talk about this all the time here on my channel. But recently, or in the past 6 to 9 months, YouTube has started rolling out this new YouTube Studio beta. It's a new look at your analytics, and there are some really cool features that are in the new YouTube Studio beta than the original one, and I wanna show you what you should be looking at and why it's really important to your channel. So let's jump on my computer and I'm gonna walk you through exactly what to be looking for and how that's going to affect the way you shift your content.
Once you're logged into your Creator Studio and you go to your analytics, if this is the screen you're seeing, you are not in the new beta studio yet. So one way to get there is to come down here under analytics and click impressions and CTR, try studio beta. Go ahead and click that and you're going to be taken to the new analytics in the studio beta. So it's a little bit different of a look. There's more graphs and it's more visually pleasing than the old analytics. But I want to show you the things that I really like looking at in the studio beta. So this number right here is what I really like looking at. This number is telling me that I currently have a 5.1 impression click-through rate. Again, in the last 28 days. What that is telling me is my title and my thumbnail is convincing people to click. So out of the 220,000 people that saw my video, whether it was in search or suggested or browse or any of those other options, out of those 220,000 people, 5.1% of people clicked through, which got me over 22,000 views. What's important to know here is if you click this little message right here, you can learn more, and it's going to tell you on average, YouTube channels can expect to see a CTR, a click-through rate between 2 and 10%. So that's what you are striving from. If you're hitting a 2% CTR, make it a goal of yours the next month to hit a 3% CTR and then a 4% CTR. I want you to get this number up higher and higher. The way to get this number up again is really focusing on eye-catching thumbnails and value-proposed titles. The next thing that I like to look at is how much YouTube is suggesting my video. You can see in the last 28 days that 15.9% of my traffic to my channel is coming from YouTube recommending my content. Ideally, I would like to get that number up more because if YouTube is recommending my content, then they obviously think it's good content and they're going to get it out to more people, which would increase my impressions as I'm hopefully increasing my CTR, which increases my views and, you know, subscribers as well. Now let's break it down by individual video. So the way you want to do that is go to videos and pull up any one of your videos that you have enough analytics on. And then you want to go back over here to analytics. And this is going to give you the overview of the data from that specific video. So you're going to see right now I have over 1,000 watch time minutes on this video. That's over 217 views. It also got me 4 brand new subscribers, so that's pretty great. Your audience retention graph is now down here, so you can follow that and see how well your audience retention did. You can also see how many likes versus dislikes you got. So this video has 100% likes, and my channel average is 95.2%, so it's getting a good like percentage. It's also showing me the latest activity in the last 48 hours that 25% of views are coming from browse features, 20% of views is coming from YouTube search. So that gives you an idea of how people are finding your videos. The next thing I want to jump over to is reach viewers. this is going to give you your click-through rate. So something I'm doing is not good, whether it's the thumbnail or the title, I could make this better since my overall channel average was that 5%. So what else I'm looking at here is 27% of my traffic is coming from YouTube recommending my content, which is higher than my channel average that I showed you earlier. Again, it's breaking down the different types of traffic sources that are driving me views, and it's also letting me see exactly the external sources that are driving me traffic as well. So this is very interesting. Socialblade.com is providing me traffic to this video. I should dig into this a little bit more. And then it's also showing me specific keywords people are searching in YouTube who are watching my videos, and the specific suggested videos that people are watching and then coming to watch this particular video. Those are some of the main pieces I like to look. You can go through here and really find some interesting data in a different perspective than the old analytics. So here in the interest viewers, you can see I'm getting over 4% average view duration on this video. And this is a really important thing. You want to ensure people are watching more content so you can actually find your end screen element click rate. For this particular video, I'm getting 3.5% click through from that end screen. So when I suggest a video at the end of my video, whereas my channel average is only 1.7%. So this is fantastic because my goal is to get people watching more of my content. That's why I suggest specific videos at the end of my videos. Then you can go over here to build an audience and you can get some more demographic information. So the majority of this watch time is coming from current subscribers, countries. I don't have any data yet since this video was recently published. So that's kind of the key things that I'm looking at here in the new studio beta. I do like some things here, and I also like some things in the classic studio analytics as well. So if you want to get back to the classic studio analytics, you can always go right here to Creator Studio Classic, and that takes you back to your original analytics dashboard.
If you want to continue to learn more about how to make your YouTube channel better to help you grow your business, make sure you click that video that's on your screen right now. Don't forget to grab my YouTube channel roadmap that's also on your screen to help you launch your YouTube channel with success. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.